and welcome to TV Coast to Coast, our weekly two-part chat about new and noteworthy shows and a look ahead to what's on your screen this week. I'm Vicki Hyman from the Star Ledger and NJ.com with Mark DeWitziak from the Cleveland Plain Dealer and Cleveland.com. Hey, Mark.
Hey there.
And and Christy Turnquist from the Oregonian and OregonLive.com. For the first part, we're looking at The Flash, the second superhero origin story to hit the small screen this fall after Gotham. It premieres Tuesday at 8 p.m. on the CW, and it's a spin-off of sorts from the network's much moodier Arrow. Christy, what did you think of the pilot?
Well, you know, speaking of the what's moody and what's not, what I've been noticing is, you know, we've had such a flood of comic book-derived movies and TV shows recently, and I think a lot of them have really overemphasized sort of the darkness. I think everybody was trying to jump on kind of the, you know, the Batman Dark Knight bandwagon. I think perhaps they were doing that as a way to show that really they're serious stories, and they're not just something from the funny books, as my dad used to call them. What I find refreshing about The Flash is that it has kind of the standard elements. It does have the tragic origin story, but it doesn't get, at least in the first episode, completely bogged down in that. And I think there's a much better balance of kind of adventure, a bit of humor, and it doesn't take itself too seriously, which again, I also find refreshing. I think it tells the story in the way that it should be told, and it doesn't feel the need to kind of put a giant coat of kind of pretentiousness all over it. Yes. Mark, what did you think?
Well, I agree completely. I like this one a lot. And I think one of the reasons I liked it was that it has a genuine sense of itself. It doesn't try to overreach. Is this as impressive a pilot as Gotham? Has as much money been spent on it? No. But I think it has a better sense of itself than Gotham. Gotham is like two shows in one. Is it going to sustain? There's a question. This one plays within itself very, very well. A very likable lead. And even as you're watching it, you're going, is some of this dialogue pretty clunky? Yeah. Are some of the characters pretty thin? Absolutely. Are there familiar moments that you feel like you've seen before? Yeah, okay, that too. But when you put it all together, it works. And it's just fun. And it lives up to its name because I think it moves so fast. There's an old saying in show business that when you're going over thin ice, your safety is in your speed. And I think that's what this is all about. I think that this one moves, and you just go right past those things, what you might object to otherwise, because it's just so much darn fun. Vicki?
Well, going back to what Christy was saying about the darkness, you know, if I have to quibble with anything about the pilot, which I really enjoyed, it's that there was like this one-note characterization of Barry. He's really engaging and likable, but he seems to be a little too unassailable. He's like fighting the bullies, and he's trying to reason with the thief, and they just ring that bell one too many times, and I wouldn't mind just a hint of darkness. But maybe that's to come. Maybe that's to come. I'm glad we all enjoyed it. You should all check it out, and we'll be coming back with the second part of our TV Coast to Coast. Thanks for watching.